Rahul Gandhi hits back, alleges Prime Minister Narendra Modi of declaring to end corruption in Manipur when he himself is corrupted. Amit Shah fills an election rally in Kankopi, says BJP will form the new government with absolute majority. And Miranda House sets up a centre for notice studies, which will focus on scientific research and education. Hello and welcome to Impact News. You're watching Primetime English News. I'm Laitha Monica with the latest news updates. All India Congress Committee's Vice President Rahul Gandhi accused the Prime Minister Narendra Modi of declaring to end corruption in Manipur when being involved in corruption himself. In his 27-minute speech at the public conference in connection with 11th Assembly elections organized by Manipur Pradesh Congress Committee at Hatta Kangjebung, he asserted that more than 2.5 years old ruling centers BJP government has not taken any developmental works in Manipur so far. He raised the question as to what happened to the Ziribam Road, which was supposed to be constructed in 100 days, and also demanded a proper reason for failure to construct the proposed sports university in Manipur. He further questioned the BJP for not consulting the Chief Minister of Manipur and people of the state while signing the Nagas Accord with NSC and IM. Rahul Gandhi asserted with regards to signing of NSC and IM and India government's framework agreement, none of the center's cabinet ministers were aware of it, but it was only the Prime Minister who knew it. He accused Modi of blaming the Chief Minister of Manipur on his visit for corruption, while he couldn't provide any documents to prove it as evidence for his accusations. On the other hand, Rahul Gandhi produced a document of Income Tax Department's raids in Sahara and Birla Group as evidence to the public, which shows that Prime Minister Narendra Modi received crores of rupees from the two companies, Sahara and Birla Group. Rahul Gandhi asked Narendra Modi's government's reason for not conducting further investigation regarding the raids. The political meeting was attended by Chief Minister Ukram Ibobi, Deputy Chief Minister Gai Khangam, MPCC President Ian Haukib, Congress government's cabinet ministers, MLAs and Congress candidates. As part of the ongoing campaign by AMSU demanding full disclosure of the framework agreement, Human Chain was formed by the Students' Union as an appeal to Indian National Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi as he visits Manipur today. Students of Regular English High School formed Human Chain, organized by All Manipur Students' Union AMSU, on Kwaikithil Airport Road, where Rahul Gandhi was expected to cross. They demanded full disclosure of the framework agreement from every political parties, emphasizing that it is not just Manipur's issue, but a national issue. Students displayed placards with slogans which read, "Manipur's integrity is more serious than election, stop political conspiracy," and waited for Rahul Gandhi's arrival. Students also shouted, "Long live Manipur, Manipur is for everyone," as Rahul Gandhi headed from airport towards Hatta Kangjebung. National President of BJP Amit Shah asserted that the 15 years of corrupted Congress government does not have the right to retain. Amit Shah made the statement at a political campaign of three BJP candidates, Nimcha Kipgen, Haukolet Kipgen and Paujalet Tauthang from Sadar Hill, held in connection with the upcoming assembly elections at Thomas Ground, Kangpopi district headquarters. He continued, if people hand over the government to BJP, there will be equal development in both the hills and the valley. He said the Congress government's trying to instill hatred amongst the communities must stop immediately. Assam MP R.P. Sharma, Finance Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma and BJP State Unit President K.S.H. Vavananda were among those present at the event. Speaking to media persons at the end of the campaign, Amit Shah maintained BJP will get absolute majority in the upcoming assembly elections and will form the new government.
और जब ये सरकार बदल कर भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार बनेगी उसी के साथ मणिपुर का विकास शुरू होगा और एक मॉडल स्टेट बनने की प्रक्रिया शुरू होगी मित्रों 15 साल तक मणिपुर की जनता ने इबोबी सिंह को मौका दिया मैं आज भारतीय जनता पार्टी की ओर से इतना ही कहना चाहता हूं एक बार भारतीय जनता पार्टी पर ये पहाड़ी विश्वास करें हम आपको इतना भरोसा दिलाते हैं कि 5 साल के अंदर ये पहाड़ियों का सारा काम चाहे वो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर का हो चाहे बेरोजगारी का हो चाहे गरीबी उन्मूलन का हो चाहे ऑर्गेनिक एग्रीकल्चर का फार्मिंग को बढ़ावा देने का काम ये सारा काम भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार 5 ही साल में एक स्पीड जेट गति से आगे बढ़ाएगी
BJP National President Amit Shah stated the Congress Party's promises are the repetition of the promises made before the 2012 election. Speaking to media persons at Classic Grande after a party rally at Kangpopi and Moirang today, Amit Shah accused Chief Minister Ukram Ibobi Singh of swindling the funds allocated by the centre and taking 10% from it. He also said that the Chief Minister is known as Mr. 10% not only in Manipur but in the whole country. He said the Congress Party in the state supports not only undergrounds but bans, blockades and fake encounters. He further said the BJP will form the government by getting absolute majority in the upcoming election. He also assured to end the economic blockade within 24 hours of government formation.
सबूत का कोई सवाल ही नहीं है हजारों आरटीआई एक्टिविस्ट ने लिया है आप भी अगर कहीं पर भी घूमकर मणिपुर की जनता को पूछेंगे तो 10% मैं दिल्ली से लेकर नहीं आया मणिपुर की जनता ही कहती है ये सारे अंडरग्राउंड ग्रुप जो चल रहे हैं वो भी सरकार की योजनाओं के कमीशन से ही चल रहे हैं देखिए एक सबसे बड़ा प्रूफ मैं आपको देना चाहता हूँ 100 योजनाएं ऐसी है जिसकी सूची अगर आपको चाहिए तो कल मेरी पार्टी जारी करेगी जिसका यूटिलाइजेशन सर्टिफिकेट मणिपुर सरकार नहीं दे सकती और उसका पूरा खर्च हो गया है तो पैसा कहाँ गया 10% वही है ये 100 योजनाओं का यूटिलाइजेशन सर्टिफिकेट नहीं आना अपने आप में बहुत बड़ा सबूत है और करप्शन की रिसीट्स नहीं होती है भैया वो रिसीट देकर करप्शन करता है क्या
National President of BJP Amit Shah assured of making Manipur a tourism hotspot if BJP comes to power today. Speaking at an event participated by 6 BJP members of Bishnupur district held at Moirang Chingai Lampak, Amit Shah further said after BJP comes to power, it will investigate the fake encounter cases and take up necessary actions against the persons involved. The 6 BJP candidates also spoke on the works they would be taking up after elected.
भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार आने के बाद हम इस सारे एनकाउंटर की इंक्वायरी करने वाले हैं जिसमें जिन्होंने भी गलत किया है उनको सजा दी जाए यहाँ के ऐतिहासिक धरोहर यहाँ का कुदरती सौंदर्य यहाँ की पहाड़ियां यहाँ के झील यहाँ के तालाब अगर करप्शन न हो तो सिर्फ भारत नहीं पूरी दुनिया के टूरिस्ट मणिपुर में आ सकते हैं भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने तय किया है कि मणिपुर के टूरिज्म को पूरे हिंदुस्तान में नंबर एक बनाने का काम भारतीय जनता पार्टी
Union HRD Minister Prakash Javedkar asserted Congress Party tries to disintegrate Manipur while BJP tries to bring unity and integrate Manipur. Prakash Javedkar made the statement at a public meeting held in connection with the flag hoisting ceremony of BJP candidate in Kaisamthong Assembly Constituency R.K. Sivachandra at Nganapithong Community Hall. Union HRD Minister mocked the Congress government's claim to provide safe drinking water to the people if it forms the government again when it could not provide in its 15 years of governance. He continued, "It is disheartening as an HRD minister to see the students in government schools hardly pass 10th examination," and said, "It is the fault of the Congress government that most people tend to go to the private schools." He maintained that if BJP forms the new government, the inconveniences facing the people to send their children to private schools will be done with, and students in private schools will be migrated to government schools.
हमें लड़ाई जो करनी है वो करप्शन के खिलाफ है, वो पानी मिलने के लिए है, वो फूड सिक्योरिटी का फूड मिलने के लिए है, ये सड़क मिलने के लिए है, और ये स्कूल, यहाँ गवर्नमेंट स्कूल नहीं चल रहा है, गवर्नमेंट स्कूल खाली है, प्राइवेट स्कूल में सब बच्चे हैं, क्यों? गवर्नमेंट के 370 स्कूल है, उसमें 70 स्कूल में 10th का रिजल्ट 0% है। मैं शिक्षा मंत्री हूँ, मैं आपको कहता हूँ, हम सबको शिक्षा देंगे, अच्छी शिक्षा देंगे, और गवर्नमेंट स्कूल भी ऐसे सुधारेंगे कि सब लोग गवर्नमेंट स्कूल में डालेंगे, प्राइवेट स्कूल में फीस नहीं भरेंगे, ये हम करके दिखाएंगे।
National spokesperson of BJP Syed Shahnawaz Hussain called Congress President Vice President Rahul Gandhi as the leader of a sinking ship as Rahul Gandhi visits Manipur for electioneering. Speaking at the one-day political meeting organized by BJP Khurai Committee at Khurai Popular High School ground, he further says the Congress party's allegation to BJP calling it a communal party is baseless. He said he himself is a Muslim and said out of 100 Muslims in Manipur, 90 believe in BJP. He expressed shocks at the prevailing conditions of roads, bridges and other deplorable conditions in the state and blamed the Congress party for not doing any developmental works in its 15 years in the state. He appealed the people to vote for BJP for a new Manipur.
ये चुनाव किसी पार्टी के लिए नहीं है, बल्कि आपके बच्चों के भविष्य के लिए है। अगर भारतीय जनता पार्टी जीतेगी, तो मणिपुर तरक्की करेगा। कोई ब्लॉकेट नहीं होगा। हिंदुस्तान में सबसे महंगा सामान नहीं, बल्कि सबसे सस्ता सामान कहीं मिलेगा, तो वो मणिपुर के अंदर मिलेगा। कि जो कांग्रेस एक डूबता हुआ जहाज है, क्योंकि जो डूबने वाला डूबेगा, और उसका जो कैप्टन है राहुल गांधी, वो आज यहाँ आया है, वो डूबते हुए जहाज का कैप्टन है।
Congress candidate in Wangkai Assembly Constituency Okram Henry asserted not to spread false, useless information to campaign for votes and rather focus on the strategy to win the election. Addressing a press meet at his residence at Mantripukhri, Henry said the BJP candidate in the constituency Y. Irabot has become senile and slammed the allegation on him regarding his educational qualification by Irabot as baseless. He continued, "Educational qualification is necessary to serve the people, but it has no relation to serving the people completely." He said, "What is more important is to be accepted by the people and to be able to give time to the people." He inquired why Irabot was talking about taking loan and if he wants to repay the loan. He continued, "The people would not believe the false information Irabot is spreading." Henry questioned if the BJP candidate was worried that he is not winning the election or if he is enraged for saying the old man's time is up.
Politics ta obviously qualification darkar leiramdre praja ga loina badu darkar oileram haitar madune aina tn 12 su kachin sam anamale na ikoina sing doctor uba sing doctor ibase scrutiny matam da yellow brush yellow dabi propaganda gi type ta tanjana tanjachana mafam da yellow brush yellow dabi loira gan dekta memory loss ki type ta amu muning jang padona praja az da atang atang gi politics ta obviously to bi danana basu hari ba miwei mi phum sing da su haijari opponent gi sondha rakpana smaina he hek togalli haina su dum takpi tobiu ke sukai di adubu praja da di utsai ma tokpi roje.
A political meeting of Trinamool Congress candidate Soraisam Manaubi in Nauriya Pakhanglakpa Assembly constituency organized by Nauriya Pakhanglakpa Trinamool Congress Committee was held at Hiangthang Maning Lekai Community Hall today. Speaking at a meeting attended by around 2,000 people from Hiangthang areas, Soraisam Manaubi assured of setting up a school for students of class 1 to 12 if an MLA is elected from the constituency. He also assured of making efforts to ensure pension funds availability throughout the year for all age pensioners as well as to provide employment opportunities for the educated and employed youth. Let's take a short break. We'll be back with more news updates. Welcome back. You're watching Primetime English News. Flag hoisting ceremony of Manipur National Democratic Front MNDF candidate in 46 cycle constituency, Vice President of MNDF, Ledzam Singson, was held today at Zomi Villa North AOC. Speaking on the occasion, President of MNDF CH Priyo Kumar alleged to Congress that it has always delayed in bringing solutions to any issues in the state until bloodsheds occur in its 15 years of governance. He further charged the Congress party of being unable to resolve the economic blockade even after the people of the hills and valley are facing immense hardships. He demanded to know what the ruling government is doing to control prices of commodities when wealthy businessmen are selling day-to-day commodities at such exorbitant prices.
Administrative point of view the yin the tarigadi district shambai sia sing the district aniga thambai sia masi yamna di maru oi ba tangai padawni ne khamjai congress na masi yamna ngalingai matam da tobi ga da da thengthan na tob sia masi khatta ekoi da lai ti ba ni mayam na iho la aba mayam na pen na bi kholaw na yam na kanchil la aba matam da da thabak oi na pai khat ba sia lai ti ba ma ni
Flag hoisting cum political meeting of All India Trinamool Congress candidate in Wankhe constituency, R.K. Priyobhatta, was held today. Speaking on the occasion, R.K. Priyobhatta said the upcoming election is a significant one for the people of Manipur. He also said it is time for the people of Wankhe constituency to understand each other. He maintained Trinamool Congress will play a major role in the new government after the election. A one-day state-level political meet of North East India Development Party and EIDP held today at Takiel Kolom Lekai in connection with the 11th Assembly election. Speaking at the event, President of the party and Samarjit asserted that the relationship between the present government and the society is like the blend of water and oil. He said it is time to change the dirty culture of politics. He continued, there can be change in the society only when its political culture is changed.
Akoi iramdam Manipur asida hojek akoina thengnari ba issue sing tongan tongan makhal gi problem sing khudi maksing asa makoi individual level singduna tasenga ohenge haina ohenge badina ta makoi gi politics ki will amadi culture aduna tasenga sagat ki ba adugum laba magi akoi gi culture sing adun makoi ne sengat ki ba issue sing oi banina Mogi, someone of a party, Wakulgi, Taku, the Gay, Amuk, Poblens, Soto Mungam Dagana, Theatre Amuk Tiny, Centre Amuk Tiny, Tiny, Amuk Amuk Tiny Dana, Lady Vissing.
Employees of Election Expenditure Monitoring Team stage a protest against inappropriate TADA allotted by the Election Commission of India. The employees include Video Surveillance Team, Video Viewing Team, Accounting Team, Media Certification and Monitoring Committee and Flying Squad. Speaking to media persons, a protesting employee said the TADA for Class 1 and 2 employees is 1,200 rupees and Class 3 employees is 1,000 rupees, while Class 4 employees are given only 200 rupees for a period beginning from 4th of the, to the end of the election process. He also said that the TADA for 20 days in the 2012 election was rupees 5,000 and condemned the decision to give only 1,000 rupees as TADA for this election.
moina thaina sanagiba 2014 da sanagiba lising amaga chani du pi ni haidna haibasi ekoi miam chi amat penadre tara suba assembly election gi tedi punna phangi adu hangdakti makoina season are ise ekoi chi January gi tang mari da saisida aroi ba oina training tore adu gi matung tang manga da gi karakpadu na ngasi bhobat mari bhot loiba gi nongan ba tang manga bhob season ga duri masaisida makoina akoi da pi ga duri ba remuneration ase tedi ase ya apun bodo piga dori bo por asi yam tina pingmali aduna ECI ge kangbu dani akoina ajik yam kanna thengna jaga duri se.
Unusual news related to election are surfacing. Reports are pouring in about an incident wherein the rooftops made of GI sets were dismantled and carried away allegedly for campaigning, first for Congress Party and then for BJP. This incident occurred yesterday afternoon around 3 p.m. at the residence of Chabongbam Ibochoba at Kumbong Maka Lekai at Konthosam constituency. Speaking to Impact News, wife of Ibochoba, CH Ibeja, says the family has been in support of Congress Party candidate and sitting MLA K. Sarat for the last 13 years. However, apart from a set of GI sets, rooftops donated by the MLA's workers 3 years ago, there are no further benefits and helps offered so far. She expressed discontentment for taking back those rooftops for supporting BJP. Looking at the plight of the family, the inhabitants of the locality donated GI sets.
Tinbal anisiga ade pukhi jima da da sahi akoi sum matam ka yang koina mangon da patana lai doi no makhari ka ji de amna na tai sa da yum lai kai re je moi na ju he na yeng da khangi poni asi bau da kanam ta na karim ta na han yeng birakte adu yeng birakta bu da ai seng na jakti ranjan je da changjara ga mana ju BJP o bini na khitang ha yeng ka gra ma tung da mana ai gi yeng birakadra khallaga ai sha na wa karang gi makha pon da nai mangon da changjara ga bo se handak ti yau bune mana bo chu ka ma ka dra ga lau gi bo ore di phai adu bu ma tin bal ani si na mangonda bhot pi da bagi phima namada tin bal ani lok thoki bje ai gi wa khanji da de thamoi ji da de khitang nuai da ba ma di poi
JC formed in connection with the killing of Khwairakpam Ningol Ningthauzam Ombi Sonia stage is set in on 26th February at her birthplace at Thamnapopi Market, demanding justice. JC member KH Pramodini demanded the suspected accused husband of late Sonia and Kishore Chandra, Pundongbam Mayai Lekai, and all those involved in her killing, as well as the persons involved in hiding her 4-year-old child, to be given due punishment by March 3.
Sonia bo haliba maki mapuroi ba amasung mahaki imong manung nubir homni gi manung da pharga mai khoi bu dandi pibi ba Sonia na pokcharamba mahaki masa nupa kipsan haliba mihat ba imong manung asida sinada ba mihat pa imong asina kipsan da koi gi matik sa ba compensation pihan ba mihat pa singa si ai koi gi desina matam sa na puthok pidana ai koi gi haliba demand khara si puthok trabadi koi makhal makha kya gi ai koi gi khongjang ban block na sing bai koi tawham thokpa makhal makhal kya gi koi khongjang changsin gani.
Manipur observed National Science Day as observed all across India today. The day was observed under the theme Science and Technology for Specially Abled Persons at Library Conference Hall, Manipur University, organized jointly by State Biotech Hub, Department of Biochemistry and Department of Library and Information Science. Vice Chancellor of the University, Professor Adhyap Prasad Pandey, Director of AIR, Dean of the University, Librarian, Research Scholars and Teachers attended the event. A book entitled Explorers of Outer Space by Professor Debananda, Department of Biochemistry, was also released at the function.
We need to create an institution or several institutions in Manipur where brilliant minds, older people, can interact with even more brilliant minds, means our students, younger, and create synergistically new ideas, innovations, and inventions. That, I believe, is the true spirit of celebrating National Science Day. No boundaries. And should I add, even the unlimited economic rockets should not be a boundary for us. We should break free of this boundary and create new institutions of excellence here and create new ideas, innovations, discoveries and inventions from the soil of Manipur.
Before we end, a quick look at the headlines once again. Rahul Gandhi hits back, alleges Prime Minister Narendra Modi of declaring to end corruption in Manipur when he himself is corrupted. Amit Shah fills an election rally in Thampupi, says BJP will form the new government with absolute majority. and Miranda House sets up a Center for Notice Studies, which will focus on scientific research and education.